July 1977, Playboy's Playmate of the Month is Sandra Theodore. She's 5'6", a Sagittarius, she loves torch song singers, wants to be an actress, and she's 34, 24, 35. It's the sort of intimate look at Playmates that readers have grown accustomed to, so here's what makes Sandra stand out. She was the subject of Playboy's first published data sheet. Now, hopeful Playmates had been filling these data sheets since the late 50s, anytime they sent in photos. It was almost like the Burger King application you filled out in high school, but with places to mention turn-ons and turn-offs. By 77, Hef had stacks of these things, and he was trying to find a way to make the pictorials more personable. So he started publishing Playmates data sheets, and they've been a staple of the Playmate pictorial ever since. But despite all this, there's one thing we may never learn about Sandra, our July 77 Playmate, whether she broke 300,000 on her favorite pinball machine. July 2012, Playboy publishes a winning interview with Charlie Sheen. A little over a year earlier, Sheen had been fired from Two and a Half Men. His ensuing meltdown is the stuff of legends. And it's in this interview that Sheen addressed all of the strangest moments, all of which Charlie admitted he came up with on the spot during interviews. Quote, "I was just winging it and it worked." Tiger blood? Charlie says that came from the tiger in Apocalypse Now, the 70s epic his father starred in. His claim that he was a warlock? Well, Charlie just liked the way warlock sounded. Adonis DNA? Quote, "I don't know what the F that was about. That was just stupid." Another thing Charlie claims to have made up? The suitcase of cocaine rumored to have led to his firing. Instead, Charlie blames it on being hospitalized from a hernia he suffered after laughing at a Dave Chappelle skit. Something tells me he's still winging it. One of the most enduring traits of a Playboy Playmate is a certain girl-next-door quality. But this wasn't always the case. In the beginning days of the magazine, Hef hired professional models to appear in the pictorials of Playboy. That changed with Janet Pilgrim in July 1955. In fact, Hef didn't even have to go as far as next door to find his next Playmate because he wrote, quote, "We found Miss July in our own circulation department, processing subscriptions, renewals, and back copy orders." That's right, Hef kept this one in-house. Janet became the subject of the magazine's first two-page centerfold, and yes, that's Hef in the background. As for Janet, readers loved her. She would be named Playmate of the Month later that same year in December and again in October of 56. The message, according to Hef, pretty girls aren't just in Hollywood, they can be found anywhere. And Janet would forever set the standard for future Playmates. But how did Hef get this girl next door to appear in the magazine? Well, she agreed to do it for a new typewriter. And that's this month in Playboy history. In June 2010, Playboy took on a whole new dimension when they named Hope Dravacik their Playmate of the Year, making her the first Playmate to appear in 3D, courtesy of some red and blue lens glasses that came with the issue. In fact, it was because of the glasses and the cost it took to make them that Hef didn't originally run with the idea when he first thought of it in the 50s.